Our topic for today is about explicit formulas for sequences. In an explicit formula, the value of the nth term does not depend on the preceding term. Rather, the nth term is expressed as a function of n, where n is a positive integer. We are going to write an explicit formula for each of the following sequences. Let us solve the first one. Number 1, 8, 27, 64. And then, we are asked to solve for the seventh term. Let's put this in a table. These are the positions of the terms. A sub n. The first term is 1, the second is 8, the third is 27, and then 64. We can actually do this mentally. Let us observe. To get 1, if we will cube this, 1 cube, you get 1. 2 cube, you get 8. 3 cube, you get 27. 4 cube, you get 64. So the formula, the explicit formula is a sub n is equals to n cube. But let me show how it is done here. A sub n, the first term is 1, and then 8, and then 27, and then 64, and these are the positions 1, 2, 3, 4. If we are going to cube this, 1 times 1 times 1, we get the first term, then 2 cube, we get the second term, 3 cube, we get the third term, and then 4 cube, we get the fourth term. The formula therefore is a sub n is equals to, these are the values of n, so n cube. This is our explicit formula. So let us solve for the seventh term. A seventh term is equals to 7 cube. 7 cube is equal to, let us use a calculator. 7 is equals to 343. Number 2. The sequence 2, 9, 28, 65. And then we are asked to solve for the seventh term using the explicit formula. Let us put this in a table. N 1, 2, 3, 4. A sub n 2, 9, 28, 65. It can be done mentally. But let me show the solutions here. A sub n, we have here 2, and then 9, and then 28, and then 65. For n, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Let us observe. If we are going to raise this to 3, 2 cubed plus 1, we get this. 3 cubed plus 1, we get 28. So, we have 1 cubed plus 1 is equals to the first term, 2. This is the 2 cubed is 8 plus 1, we get 9. 3 cubed is the 27 plus 1 is 28. And then 4 cubed plus 1 is equal to 65. So our formula is A sub n is equal to n cubed plus 1. Now, we are going to use this to obtain the seventh term. A raised sub n is equal to 7 cubed plus 1, but we know already 7 cubed. We will just add 1 to that. So we'll have say 3, 4, 4. Okay, next. Number 3. The sequence 3, 5, 7, 9, and then 12th term. Okay. N 1, 2, 3, 4. A sub N, I have 3, 5, 7, 9. A sub n, we have 3, 5, 7, 9, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Let us observe. If I will multiply this by 2 and add 1, I'll get this times 2 plus 1, 5 times 2 plus 1, 7 times 2 plus 1, 9. So 2 times the position and then plus 1, I will get 3. 2 times 2 plus 1 is 5, the second term. 2 times 3 plus 1 is equals to 7. 2 times 4 plus 1 is equals to 9. Therefore, A sub n is equals to 2n plus 1. This is our explicit formula. So, A sub 12 is equals to 2 times 12 plus 1 is equals to 25. Number 4. The sequence 3, 9, 27, 81. And then we are asked to solve for the 8th term. Let's put this in a table. And 1, 2, 3, 4. We have A sub n, 3, 9, 27, 81. A sub n, 3, 9, 27, 81. N, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let us observe. How are we going to get 3? Times 3, 3 times 3, will not get 9. 3, 3. If we will raise this to 1, raise this to 2, get 9. Okay. So, 3 raised to n is equals to 3. 3 raised to 2, or 3 squared, is equals to 9. So, 3 raised to 3 is equals to 27. And then here, 3 raised to 4 is equals to 81. So, our formula is 3 raised to n. This will be our explicit formula. Let us solve for the 8th term. Is equals to 3 raised to 8. What is 3 raised to 8? Sixty-five, sixty-one.